everyone please stand and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of the national anthem performed tonight by the Merrimack High School Marching Band under the direction of Mrs. Patricia Cunningham.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to tonight's broadcast of the Alvirne Broncos taking on your Merrimack Tomahawks, coming to you live from Merrimack High School tonight. As always, I am joined on commentary by the one and only Ralph Carpentier. Ralph, thanks so much for joining us tonight. We have another exciting matchup on our hands here. This Merrimack team, don't let the record fool you at 1-4. They have been putting up fireworks all season long. They've been a very exciting team to watch, and they're really building some great momentum here to continue to build off, not only for the rest of this year, but going into next season as well. Ralph, which way do you see this tonight's game going?
I think you've got two teams whose records don't represent the play they've put out on the football field today. And we're looking at a close-fought, hard-fought battle between two very good NHIAA teams.
And, of course, as always, joined in studio tonight by Assistant Media Services Coordinator Justin Slez and Media Assistant David McGinnis on camera over at the stadium. Want to say thank you to both of them for all their help and support tonight as we get ready for what should be a very good game between two rivals here as they have just completed the coin toss here. See both teams heading out to the middle of the field here as we should be getting ready to kick this one off here shortly. Beautiful night, beautiful weather tonight down at the stadium for tonight's game. Nice, crisp. It's still warm night, Ralph, wouldn't you say?
It's like that perfect weather. It's a flannel weather. Might be a little warm where you roll the sleeves up early, but by the end of the night, you're going to pull those sleeves down and cuddle up.
Yeah, good night definitely to snuggle up underneath the blanket and really feel the fall vibe, so to speak, here. Is there's nothing that is more fall than a little bit of football underneath the Friday night lights here as we get set to kick this one off here in just a few moments.
Dave, I think it's also important to mention the last time we saw this Merrimack team at home, they did pull out an amazingly close win against Nashua South. So I look forward to another tight battle like that one.
Absolutely. Merrimack has played all of their opponents quite tough all season long here. So I'd expect tonight to be no different whatsoever as they're going to be looking on to put a show on for the home crowd here tonight.
Allard on to kick for Alvirne.
As Alvirne here gets ready to kick off here. And it's going to be an onside kick. Merrimack's going to be able to field that one cleanly. And they're going to take over here on offense with some excellent field position to begin this game.
Good hands there from the up man. Definitely a tough kick to get hold of early, but great play from Merrimack there.
Absolutely. Good special teams right there being displayed. Good coaching. Good preparation right there.
Merrimack
recovers. Best to not be surprised by that onside kick.
First and 10, starting from their 43-yard line.
So Merrimack will take over here on offense, led by the senior Kyle Crampton, standout senior Kyle Crampton, here at their own 43-yard line. First and 10, Merrimack here. Crampton from the shotgun, handing off. That ball handed off to number 9, that is Romello Hyde, who's had himself a great year as a junior.
Carrier.
Able to take that one past midfield and into Alvin Bronco territory.
Tackled by Allard. Gain of 9 on that
we'll
play.
See Merrimack
second
feature a spread
one.
Offense tonight.
Maybe
as Crampton
two.
Will operate almost exclusively from the shotgun with 4 wide receivers, that spread offense. Another handoff to Hyde right here. Good strong run right at the point of contact, able to push that one forward
Hyde
for a good game.
Carry. Gains 4 on the play.
Okay, but really impressive what they're able to do out of the shotgun formation with 4 wide. Really able to get a lot of movements forward from their running back.
Alvirne, 45-yard line.
No question at all there. Again, opting to keep it on the ground, handing it off to Hyde again. Nice run right up the middle. Attacking the interior of the Alvirne Bronco defense is Hyde, able to carry some tacklers with him for a very nice gain on that inside run.
Gain of about 20 on the play, good enough for a tomahawk.
Just about a 20-yard gain right there in first down for Merrimack.
Romello Hyde looked really good there. A little bit more burst than I'm used to seeing. He's got a lot of power behind his runs, but a lot of speed and quickness there.
A lot of speed and quickness being displayed right there, along with that tough ability to run inside. As the Bronco is ready for that handoff, as they're able to swallow that one up behind the line of scrimmage, Hyde's going to be brought down for a short loss on that play.
DJ Tebow in there for the stop for the Broncos.
Loss of 4 on the play.
It's going to go down officially as a 4-yard loss here.
Second and 14, Tomahawks.
Crampton back to pass. Good pressure by Alvirne. That play, though, is going to be blown dead. This one could be coming back here, possibly a false start by Merrimack. Oh, looks like this one is going to go against Alvirne.
Penalty on Alvirne. Encroachment.
And it's going to be an encroachment call right here on the Broncos. This one's going to come up 5 yards. Giving Merrimack perhaps a more amenable second down situation
second
here.
Nine for the Tomahawks.
Crampton again bringing the spread offense back up to the line of scrimmage here. He's got Hyde in the backfield with him. Play fake to Hyde. He's going to step back. He's going to scramble. Crampton's quick on his feet. He's inside the 10, inside the 5. Bring it into the red zone here, real close to the Alvirne Bronco goal line. Nice run right there by the senior, Kyle Crampton.
Love the play fake there, and then a really decisive run there when he looked like all the reads had been covered, taking that ball inside the 5.
Going through his progressions quickly right there, Ralph, and identifying that he didn't have anybody open downfield, didn't want to force it, and instead relying on his athleticism right there as the senior takes it on a nice gain. Hand off again to Hyde. Going to be just short of the goal line here.
Second and goal from the 1.
Second and goal, 1 yard before reaching pay dirt here. Crampton handing it off to Hyde. This one's going to be close here.
Just shy of the goal.
I like Merrimack going with the no huddle there, looking just to snap it quick and try to get in. It didn't work out the way they planned, but they've got another down or two here to punch this in.
Still plenty of time here. Hyde again looking to run it inside, but the Alvirne Bronco defense is up to the task here of protecting that goal line.
Bronco defenders.
And this is going to bring up fourth down here.
Fourth and goal from the 1.
Looks like about under a yard to go, as they could not be any closer to scoring a touchdown here. Let's see what head coach Kip Jackson decides to go with. What are they going to dial up here on 4th and 1? Opting not to attempt the field goal here. Crampton in shotgun. He's got 2 backs with him back there. Trying to draw Alvirne off sides.
Penalty Broncos for encroachment. Half the distance of the goal.
So that's another encroachment penalty on the Broncos. They're going to move that ball up.
Dave, it's an interesting play there looking for the encroachment penalty. You would think, oh, it's not that big of a distance. It's only half the distance of the goal on that play. But you get that ball just a bit closer, it is a game of inches.
Every inch matters here. High snap. Crampton Avery will bring that one under control. Let's see if he can scramble free here. Throws that one away, perhaps wisely. As unfortunately, what was looking like a very successful opening drive here for the Tomahawks is going to end with a turnover on downs. As Crampton having some issues handling the high snap there. And the Broncos were able to blow that play up in the backfield. Interesting situation, though, here, Ralph, for Alvirne. First and 10, inside their own one-yard line. They could not be any closer to their own goal line. You have to figure that Tomahawk defense is going to be licking their chops here.
Absolutely, Dave. I think this is a play where you're looking to get that stop behind line of scrimmage for a safety, and it makes it difficult here play-calling-wise for Alvirne.
It's number 15, Jacob Bradshaw in shotgun. He's going to hand this ball off. They're going to go up the middle. Merrimack defense keying in on that immediately, as they're going to stop that one right at the line of scrimmage for what looks to be no gain. Might have gotten half a foot there.
Gain of 2 on the play.
They're officially going to call it 2 yards.
Broncos on their 3-yard line.
Alvirne now 2nd and 8 on their own 3-yard line. And that's number 15, Jacob Bradshaw, the senior, back in the shotgun, empty backfield. Bradshaw fakes the handoff here. He's able to get that one away. That pass is complete to number 84. That is Brendan Graham, the senior captain.
Bradshaw's pass complete to Graham.
Nice play right there as they're able to buy themselves some breathing room and they pick up a first down. If you're enjoying the game tonight, remember to check out more MHS sports action from Merrimack TV on your Roku, Amazon, Fire TV, or Apple TV device. Make sure you download the Cablecast ScreenWeave to watch the next game live on your big screen. And as always, you're watching Merrimack TV, your community, your voice. Handoff again here, that one to number 17, that's Bryant Montgomery, the senior.
Montgomery on the carry. Tripped up by Gendron.
Trying to bounce that one outside. Merrimack defense able to pursue that one. Bring the ball carrier down before turning into a bigger gain. Nonetheless, gain of 4. Leaves a 2nd and very manageable 6 yards here for the Alvirne Broncos. 6:20 here left in the first quarter. Bradshaw taking the snap, drops back. He looks to his left. He fires. That pass is going to fall incomplete. Pass intended for number 7, Alvin Toomey, senior tight end.
Bring up 3rd and 6 for the Broncos.
And this will bring up a 3rd and 6 here on the 17-yard line.
Big 3rd down here, Dave. Merrimack has a chance to force a punt here from Alvirne and really keep that field position in their favor.
Yeah, this could potentially be a field position flipper right here. Merrimack is able to get off the field here in 3rd down.
Graham, the intended receiver, flags.
Got a flag down here on the play after what appeared to be an incomplete pass.
Interference penalty assessed against the Tomahawks.
And there will be a pass interference penalty here assessed against the Merrimack Tomahawks defense. Tough break there for Merrimack. Alvirne's certainly not complaining, though, as they get a new lease on life on this down, as it'll be first and 10.
First and 10 Broncos from their 32-yard line.
From their own 32-yard line here. And just like that, they're able to get out of the shadow of their own end zone here, as they're now up on the 32-yard line. Quarterback keeper here. Straight up the middle. This one's going to go for a good chunk of yardage. Again, that's number 15, the senior Jacob Bradshaw, the quarterback, on the keeper, able to take that one right up the middle.
Gain of 13 on that play.
Nice run right there. 13-yard gain and a first down here for the Alvirne Broncos. First and 10, ball on the 45-yard line here. Alvirne in the shotgun. Three wide receivers, a tight end, and a running back. That handoff is going to go right up the middle to number 17, Bryant Montgomery, for a short gain.
Montgomery, the ball carrier. Stopped by Duke.
Outside the pass interference penalty, Dave, we're looking at a pretty methodical, deliberate drive here from the Alvirne Broncos.
Certainly are, Alf, and taking advantage of mistakes by the other team is always a key to winning any football game, especially at the high school level. You really have to be able to capitalize on turnovers and inopportune times for penalties in order to be successful here. And Alvirne marching up the field here, ball almost at midfield on their own 48-yard line. Man in motion was number 84, that's Brennan Graham. Handoff to the motion side. Ball carrier Bryant Montgomery, it's number 17, the senior.
Stopped by Goodwin.
Everyday Shea Goodwin on the stop there, the senior, who's had himself a heck of a season all over the field, both on offense, defense, and special teams. If you remember, he had two kick returns for touchdowns.
Really a complete player there, Shea Goodwin. Someone who, if he was a baseball player, might be considered a five-tool athlete.
A five-tool athlete indeed, absolutely. Not sure if Shea plays baseball, but wouldn't surprise me if he did here. Third and 5 here. Alvirne back in the shotgun. Ball on the 50-yard line. That pass.
Bradshaw's pass complete.
Is complete.
To Toomey.
Complete to Toomey here. Nice pickup right there as Alvirne continue to move the ball.
Gain of 19 on that play. First and 10 Broncos.
Unfortunately, the Tomahawks unable to get off the field earlier in the drive after a third down pass interference call went against them. And Alvirne, since that time, has been able to march the ball down the field now. Now moving into Merrimack territory, knocking on the door of the red zone with 3:33 here left in the first quarter. And the ball carrier there, number 17, that's Bryant Montgomery, the senior. Another short game.
Pursuit on the tackle there from defensive back and quarterback Kyle Crampton.
Crampton getting it done on both sides of the ball all season long here.
Gain of 2 on the play. Second and 8.
And let's see what the Broncos have dialed up here on offense on second down and 8.
And we have a timeout, Alvirne.
And Alvirne's going to opt to take a timeout here. Are you interested in learning more about Merrimack TV? Would you like your own show on the community channel? Well, if you are interested, make sure you email Nicholas and Justin, MerrimackTV@merrimacknh.gov, to inquire about how you can get your own show on the channel. Ralph, if you had a show on Merrimack TV, what do you think it would be about? I think a football show would probably be a good one. Maybe like a tailgating show, football snacks type of show. That's kind of been the theme for this year. I feel like you'd be able to have a really good production there.
Yeah, I had to think about that for a second, and I start to think about our loyal viewers that watch in the garage and all the snacks they tend to have. And I think a show about snacks like buffalo chicken dip or, you know, soft Bavarian pretzels with some cheese dip.
Soft Bavarian pretzels with some cheese dip. Now that, my friend, is a decadent combination. That sounds like that would be episode 3 of season 1, would be the Bavarian pretzel and cheese episode. as Alvirne here back in the shotgun. Handoff again here to number 17. That's Montgomery.
Montgomery on the carry.
Long sustained drive right here by the Alvirne Broncos.
Yeah, this first quarter is moving fairly quickly. And we only kicked off. It feels like maybe exactly 15 minutes ago at this point, with 2 minutes left in the first quarter.
Absolutely. Clock really moving here. Hard to believe that this drive started inside the Alvirne 1 yard line here, after the Tomahawks, unfortunately, were unable to convert on fourth and goal.
Dude, we were talking about it being a field flipper. Well, it might have been flipped the other way.
Looking for a little wide receiver screen pass right there. Ball is complete to number 21. That's Anthony Ferrello, the senior wide receiver. Also plays defensive back on the other side of the ball as well.
Gain of a yard on that play. Bring up fourth and four for the Broncos. Ball placed at the Tomahawk 30-yard line.
This would be just about a fourth and four right here for the Broncos, opting to leave their offense out there. That is a lengthy field goal to kick, especially at this level. Fourth and five. Let's see what the Broncos here can dial up. Is the Merrimack defense here looking to stand tall. Dropping back to pass. He fires. That pass is going to be complete. Good zip on that ball. That pass complete to number 21, Anthony Ferrillo.
Ferrillo with the reception.
Yeah, a lot of mustard on that ball there. Something that we could also add to those Bavarian pretzels.
Absolutely. I think a good mustard, a good high-quality mustard pairs very nicely with the pretzel. I would agree with you.
On that play. First and 10, Alvirne. From the Tomahawk 20-yard line.
Alvirne continue to march downfield here. Converting a nice pass there on fourth down. Handoff again goes to number 17. That's Bryant Montgomery. He's been a busy man on this drive.
Montgomery, the ball carrier.
Under a minute left here in the first quarter.
Tackled by Zach R. Gain of a half a yard on that.
So we're under 30 seconds left here in the first quarter. A quarter where Alvirne has pretty much possessed the ball exclusively. Only had two possessions thus far this game. Alvirne in the middle of a drive that started inside their own 1 yard line. Drops back to pass. That is intended for number 20, Colin Fay.
Bradshaw's pass complete to Fay.
Hey, Dave, it's really impressive. What a drive. To start inside your own 1 yard line, really be backed up there on the spot for Merrimack to really take advantage. And Alvirne's been really tenacious and aggressive moving the ball down here, now ending the first quarter with the ball inside the 20.
Good ball control drive right here by Alvirne as that concludes the first quarter. So we'll flip field and get ready for the second quarter.
It doesn't shock me that it's their approach today as well. You think about Crampton and this offense with Shea Goodwin and Ryan Turley and Romello Hyde out there. These are all guys that are pretty explosive, make some big plays, and if you want to keep them off the field, it's probably a smart thing to do.
Try to possess the ball. Absolutely. Keep that offense at bay by making them stay on the sidelines. The town of Merrimack's media division is branded Merrimack TV. The division is funded by way of franchise fees from Comcast cable subscribers in Merrimack. The town of Merrimack has a community TV facility located at 6 Babusick Lake Road, which is where Ralph and I are coming to you from tonight. Our three cable channels reach over 8,000 homes. We're accessible online at merrimacktv.com and on Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV devices via Cablecast ScreenWeave. So make sure you stay informed. Follow Merrimack TV on social media. Subscribe to Merrimack TV on YouTube. And thank you for watching Merrimack TV. As always, this is Merrimack TV, your community, your voice, as we get ready here to kick off the second quarter. Alvirne in the middle of the drive that pretty much milked the clock in the entire first quarter. It started inside their own 1 yard line. Had a lot of excitement, a pass interference call that enabled them to pick up a first down. They're able to pick up a convert on a fourth down to keep the drive alive. Merrimack defense here really trying to get off the field. Good rush right there by Merrimack. They're able to flush number 15. Again, that's Jacob Bradshaw out of the pocket. He's able to make something out of nothing right there.
Brought down by Atkinson. Gain of 6 yards on that last play.
6 yard gain is going to leave us with a fourth and two here
for the Broncos.
Alvirne already successful once on fourth down on this drive. It'll be interesting to see what happens here.
They've converted once. Let's see if they can do it again here. Getting it done both through the air and on the ground. From the pistol formation. Rolling out to his left. That pass is going to be complete to number 21. That is Anthony Ferrillo, and that is going to be an Alvirne Broncos touchdown.
Big play there from the Broncos, going from their 1 yard line, 99 yards on the drive, almost a full quarter in length, ending in a touchdown. Pretty impressive drive from the Broncos. It'll be interesting to see what Merrimack's counterpunch will look like.
Absolutely. Again, important to note, the Merrimack offense, they did receive the ball to start the game, and they were able to drive the ball downfield all the way inside the Alvirne 1 yard line, but unfortunately they weren't able to punch it in there. But Alvirne, after taking over, after a turnover on downs from Merrimack, drive the ball basically 99 and a half yards in for a touchdown right there. So a great drive by the Alvirne Broncos. Still plenty of time left in this game here. 11:02 left in the second quarter. Merrimack TV has committed to live broadcasts of 10 MHS Varsity home games this fall. Check out our sports coverage calendar at merrimacktv.com. If you'd like to see an away game, check out the New Hampshire Coalition for Community Media's network calendar. Our peers in other communities may be covering your away games live on their channels and live streams. Find Merrimack away game coverage at www.nhccm.org/network. Really, really amazing website. Highly recommend you check it out. Great tool to see incredible high school sports action from all across the state. And an amazing way to keep up with your Merrimack Tomahawks. And speaking of trying to keep up here, the Alvirne Broncos trying to keep up on special teams.
He could go all the way.
Touchdown Tomahawks here. That was number 48.
What a run.
That was Antonio, and I'm going to try to get his last name right here. DePetri Antonio. Thank you. Ralph, you helped me out there. Normally,
I may have been practicing that for a while once I noticed the name on the call sheet.
Well, I'm glad you practiced it, and congratulations to Antonio for an electric play right there. As Merrimack able to strike back, we go from one offense essentially taking 9 minutes to score a touchdown to Merrimack answering immediately, again coming through with the electric special teams right there.
And Schmidt's extra point is good.
As Antonio DePetri, Antonio, the freshman, scoring a touchdown right there. Showing off some wheels. And we have ourselves a tie ball game here, Ralph.
Wow. What a change in momentum there. We had Alvirne go 99-plus yards for that touchdown drive after stopping Merrimack inside the one. And then we have a DePetri Antonio touchdown on the kickoff. Whew.
Quite a play right there. Quite a momentum shift. Although, if you're the Merrimack defense, you might be looking at your kick returner right now and saying, maybe you could have pulled up at the 10-yard line, given us a little bit of a breather.
And the kick is Merrimack recovers that kick there.
Merrimack recovering the kick, the ball traveling the appropriate distance to pick it up.
What a great answer to your question, Dave. You thought maybe the defense might have wanted a little more time on the sidelines. Well, that recovery of the onside kick just gave them
they
that.
They must have gone up to head coach Kip Jackson and said, you know what, why don't we onside kick this one? We need a few more minutes. great play right there. Again, special teams. It's been a calling card for Merrimack all season long, and again, they're able to come through here as Kyle Crampton and company come out here on first and 10. Ball right at the 50-yard line. Crampton drops back to pass. He fires one left. Deep ball. That one intended for Shea Goodwin. Looks like it's going to fall incomplete.
Just out of reach. Goodwin, the intended receiver. Second and 10, Tomahawks.
Goodwin, who's had himself a heck of a senior season here. Almost came away with a real long gain right there. Near miss, but you have to figure that Crampton's going to go back in that direction at some point.
Yeah, you kind of have to. He's got a lot of talent there in Goodwin. He trusts his arm. He trusts what Goodwin can do with his hands. I think you look his way as much as you can.
And on this senior night at Merrimack High, Hyde on the handoff. That's going to be a short gain. Off tackle right.
Hyde on the carry.
Alvirne defense doing a great job. Moving sideline to sideline there to stop that run before he was able to get around the edge and turn that upfield. As this will bring up third and seven here. Ball on the Alvirne 47-yard line with 10:15 left here in the second quarter. Crampton looking to throw. He fires one. That ball is going to fall incomplete.
Crampton's pass incomplete. We'll bring up fourth and seven.
And the Broncos defense here able to stand tall as they're going to force Merrimack to call upon the punting unit.
Page on to punt for the Tomahawks. Dufour on to receive for the Broncos.
A little too hot to handle there. And Alvin's going to take control of that ball just outside the red zone here.
Tough break right there for the Merrimack Tomahawks on special teams as Alvirne is set to take over here with some excellent field position.
Dave, you talked about the importance of special teams, but you saw it right there. Three consecutive plays. You had a return for a touchdown, recovered onside kick, and then a difficult snap to handle. And you've got three plays completely changed the momentum of the game back and forth and back and forth there. Pretty impressive. It's why Bill Belichick has 14 gunners and 16 punt protectors on that roster every year.
That's right. That's why we cut all the good players in New England. But to your point, though, you really do have to be competent in all three phases of the game if you're going to be successful here. And you're seeing the importance of special teams, you know, really coming alive. As Alvirne looking down the sidelines, he's got a man open. That pass is complete to Cole Bucknum for a touchdown, the junior.
Nice pass there from Bradshaw. Really impressive to see. Something we've seen before in some of these Merrimack games is there's sometimes a height differential for teams, and Alvirne looks to have some height on the outside there and at the quarterback position, and they've attempted to utilize that today, and I think that's a really smart play from Coach Tarek Roth, and it'll be interesting to see how Kip Jackson's team responds to that.
Yeah, it certainly is a sound strategy to use the talents and the advantages that you may have, and certainly throwing to taller receivers out on the perimeter can be very tough to defend right there. As Jacob Bradshaw was able to identify that one, complete that touchdown pass to the junior, Cole Bucknum. As this has been an exciting game, as the Alvirne Broncos are ahead of your Merrimack Tomahawks 14-7. Let's see if Merrimack can reach back down into their bag of tricks here on kickoff returns and take another one back to the house.
They've had 21 points in the first three or less than 3 minutes of the second quarter. The entire first quarter was dominated primarily by one drive with two others accompanying it. Pretty impressive shift in momentum. Reminds me a lot of that Super Bowl 38 Patriots versus Panthers, where there was no points scored in that first quarter, then a second quarter for the ages, a quiet third, and another fourth. Let's see what we're in for today.
Well, Ralph, from broadcasting Merrimack high school football games all the way to NFL films, that's where I see you going next. Ralph Ever, the Patriots historian and diehard fan of Tomahawk Nation, as you all are joining us tonight. Merrimack's going to field that kick. Alvirne able to cover. And Kyle Crampton and company will take over on offense here with 9:51 left in the second quarter.
Alvirne going back to the squib kick there, which we've seen a lot of this year from most teams, possibly there in response to the return for a touchdown previously. But it is something we've seen as kind of a consistent strategy, especially in a very intricate part of the game that a lot of players don't necessarily get a lot of time to focus on comparatively when you're studying for exams and homework and also, you know, playing multiple positions.
Playing multiple positions. As many of you may well know, these incredible student-athletes getting it done both in the classroom and on the field of play, most of them are playing two positions throughout the game. They're playing offense and they're playing defense here, so it's hard to cover every element of football throughout practice and throughout the course of the week, but always very impressive to see how well these teams are able to execute week after week in all three phases of the game here. Crampton taking a high snap, hand off to Hyde. Hyde with a nice run right there, having a very productive game thus far, as he's going to take that into Alvirne Bronco territory here and rack up another Tomahawks first down.
It's amazing to me that as the season progresses, Romello Hyde seems to be getting faster and faster. Really, really impressive.
Crampton fakes a jet sweep right there. That pass is going to be complete to, I believe that was number two. Every day, Shea Goodwin, the senior, able to bring that one in. And Merrimack continuing to methodically move the ball ahead here with 8:41 here left in the second quarter. Picking up the tempo here, handoff again to Hyde. Hyde taking this one right up the middle. Man, he is a tough ball carrier to bring down with a nice run, dragging some tacklers along with him.
Dave, yeah, you're really seeing a lot here from Hyde, really getting yardage both from quickness and quick bursts and cuts to carrying defenders on his back. He's getting some holes there from the offensive line. And it's really impressive considering what this offense usually does with the spread, throwing the ball.
Yeah, Romello Hyde really relying on some great vision to find the open holes there. That ball is deep, and it's going to be brought in and caught by who else, ladies and gentlemen, but Shea Goodwin on the streak pattern. Crampton able to drop a dime in there. Goodwin able to come up with an amazing fingertip catch, diving in the end zone for a Merrimack Tomahawks touchdown. What an amazing play right there. Crampton recognizing the single coverage and able to deliver that ball to his standout senior wideout. As this game, pending the point after, will be tied. Looks like we have some movement up front here.
I'm curious, if this is on Alvirne, do you potentially try to punch this in for the extra point? It is offsides.
Offsides, it will move the ball half the distance to the goal line.
And that 2-1.
Encroachment penalty. It might not seem like much, but that 1 yard difference could be really important here, as it does look like Merrimack's going to opt to leave the kicking team out there.
Still early. 2 points isn't really necessary at this point, and we saw what Alvirne did when they clamped down last time in that area. No good.
And that kick is going to be no good. As Alvirne leads 14-13 here, Crampton able to drive the Merrimack offense back down the field, completing a touchdown strike to Shea Goodwin.
27 points, Dave, in a four-minute span. This is an exciting, exciting second quarter, especially for those fans who love offense.
If you love offense and you love fireworks, that's what we're getting here tonight. As both these teams here look prepared to play, they're dialed in on offense. Seeing some good sustained drives, some fireworks through the passing game. We've seen a kickoff return for a touchdown. Shea Goodwin here will kick off for the Merrimack Tomahawks. Another squib kick right there. And Alvirne's going to opt to just field that one cleanly, sit on it, and send their offensive unit out here. Barnway on the return. As Jacob Bradshaw and company will come back out here on offense for the Alvirne Broncos. Bradshaw thus far looking really strong through the air here. We got a pair of senior quarterbacks. that are duking it out here in Crampton and Bradshaw. Bradshaw's looked great. He's thrown a long touchdown. Crampton's thrown a long touchdown.
Yeah, I've been really impressed with both quarterbacks and their vision on the field, really hitting some amazing passes. You had that first touchdown there from Bradshaw on a shorter pass, and the second pass was an amazing back shoulder throw to the receiver who had great body control. And then Shea Goodwin laying out for a pass that was placed in the only spot it needed to be.
And of course, he comes up with it, because that's what Shea Goodwin does. He makes plays, ladies and gentlemen.
All day, every day.
7:43 left here in the second quarter.
Second and five Broncos from their 39-yard line.
Bradshaw again here back in the shotgun. He's got one running back with him back there and four wide receivers. And trips to the left. Plenty of time to throw. He's going to let one rip. Fires one deep. That pass is going to fall incomplete. Potentially a dangerous pass there. It looked like Merrimack had that one pretty well covered. That ball looks like it was intended for number 21, Anthony Ferrillo, who already has a touchdown reception earlier this game. It'll be third and five here, ball on the Alvirne Bronco 39-yard line. Bradshaw again, back in shotgun, spread formation. Joined by Bryant Montgomery in the backfield. Flag's gonna be thrown here. And that's gonna be a false start on the Alvirne Broncos. It's gonna make this a bit more of a difficult third down to pick up here.
Move the sticks back 5 yards. It'll be third and 10.
Third down, 10 yards to go here. In what has been a very exciting game thus far. Each team putting a pair of touchdowns on the board. The difference here being one missed extra point by Merrimack.
We saw how that impacted the game between Merrimack and Nashua South. Let's see what that plays into the game today.
Good pressure right there by the Tomahawks. Good coverage too, but number 21, that is Anthony Ferrillo again, able to come up with another reception. Good tough catch right there in traffic. As Bradshaw able to deliver that one under some serious pressure.
Gain of 12 on that play, first and 10 Broncos from their 46.
Both teams here doing a great job moving the ball through the air. Bradshaw here back in the pistol formation. And he's going to hand that ball off again to Montgomery. Straight ahead gain right there. Are you enjoying the game tonight? Well, check out more MHS sports action from Merrimack TV on your Roku, Amazon Fire TV, or Apple TV device. Download Cablecast ScreenWeave to watch the next game live on the big screen. This is Merrimack TV, your community, your voice as we get ready here for a second and four. Ball in the Merrimack 48-yard line, man in motion here. And that's going to be another handoff. Nice tackle right there by Shea Goodwin, able to wrap up the ball carry. That was Bryant Montgomery.
Montgomery on the carry, tackled by Goodwin.
And this is going to bring up third down. Looks like third and a fairly long two right here. Ralph, third and two, what are you thinking here? Play action, do you hand the ball off, play it safe? Or do you go back to the passing game knowing you've had so much success through the year thus far?
Yeah, I'm going to lean towards the latter, Dave. It does feel like the passing game has worked for them on these third downs, whether it's short or long. So let's see what we see here.
And pass it is here as Merrimack's able to generate some pressure. Bradshaw thrown across his body. He's going to have to throw that one out of bounds. Probably a smart play right there.
Good call from Merrimack there to bring a little bit of pressure on the outside, knowing that Alvirne had been a little bit more successful throwing the ball on these third downs. And it looks like we're going to get a punt here from Alvirne. So great stand from the Merrimack Tomahawks.
I believe that was number 65, Tyler Atkinson, on the pressure for the Merrimack defense. As Alvirne here will get ready to punt this one away with 5:24 here left in the first half. High snap, but he's able to field that one, get the kick away. And that ball is going to go out of bounds. Can't quite tell where that went out of bounds, but we'll get the official spot here in just a moment.
Tomahawks will start from their 31-yard line.
Interested in learning more about Merrimack TV? Would you like your own show on the community channel? Well, then email Nicholas and Justin, MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov. Crampton with a hard snap count right there, trying to draw them off sides. And he's able to do so successfully. Crampton really mixing up his cadence tonight on the line of scrimmage, Ralph. He's been able to draw a few of these penalties thus far.
Yeah, it's been pretty impressive. He had that one inside the one that got the ball really close there. But as we said, a game of inches makes it really difficult to punch it in, no matter how close you are.
Alvirne only rushing four, but able to get to Crampton. As he's able to deliver that one again to Shea Goodwin.
Gone.
Looking like Brady to Moss in 2007. What a touchdown toss that was. Goodwin's second of the game as Crampton able to hook up with his favorite target, the one and only everyday Shea Goodwin, the senior, for another long touchdown pass here as Merrimack is going to pull ahead 19-14 with 5:10 left in the second quarter. What a pitch and catch right there, Ralph.
Yeah, incredible. Beautiful ball, great arc, tight spiral, dropped right in there.
Dropping another dime in there. Crampton had people in his face, too. That was a good, strong Broncos pass rush. As Merrimack able to convert that extra point here as they will pull ahead 20-14 on a quick strike. Crampton a good win right here as both teams not afraid to take to the air. As Merrimack here charging back in what has been a back and forth battle here.
Dave, it's been pretty impressive. I mean, you look at that first quarter, no points, three total drives, one from Merrimack, two from Alvirne. Alvirne takes one of those 99 yards, finishes with a scoring drive in the next quarter, and we've exploded now for 34 points between both teams. Incredibly exciting.
Yeah, it's hard to believe that you only saw two drives in the first quarter. Both teams opting to control the clock, particularly Alvirne, taking their time in a methodical drive to score their first touchdown of the game. But since that point, we've seen kick returns, we've seen long touchdown passes. We've seen a few long touchdown passes. What more could you want on a Friday night, Tomahawks Nation, as we thank you for joining us here on Merrimack TV.
The only thing I can think of, Bavarian pretzels, my friend.
Soft Bavarian pretzels is the snack of the night here, according to my man on color commentary, Ralph Carpentier. Ralph, I will say, and I'll share with Tomahawks Nation, that Ralph and I did make a pilgrimage to Gillette Stadium, the Razor, on Sunday night. And we both enjoyed some excellent sausage, pepper, and onion subs while we were at the game. I think that is an excellent football snack.
I actually did not have a sausage and pepper
sub. That's right,
I had two pretzels. That's right, two pretzels.
Well, their 47-yard line. I just think they were so good that maybe I should have gotten two of them.
I kind of wish I had gotten one as well.
Well, perhaps we'll go back down there again and rectify that wrong as the Alvirne Broncos take over here on offense. First and 10 from the 47-yard line. That's going to be handoff right up the middle. Short gain right here. Merrimack defense stout to the stop.
I really do wish I would have had a sausage that second time around. Rookie mistake on my part. The first pretzel, always incredible. They got those fired up right away when you get to the stadium.
Oh, they're nice and fresh and they're
warm. That second one, not as much.
Not as warm.
Should have went
more
sausage
stale,
that time.
Maybe
a hot dog. Yeah. Anything else would have been a little bit better. The key word is soft when it comes to a soft pretzel.
Soft pretzel. It's got to be warmly baked, fresh out of the oven. It's the time frame in which you receive it is important here. As the Broncos drop back to pass, throwing a ball up there intended for number 84. That's Brendan Graham, the senior captain, tight end. Throwing that one up where only Graham could get it, but unfortunately he is unable to come down with that high pass.
Third and 8 Broncos.
Looks like Kyle Crittenden just enough there to keep him from making that catch, something that Rodney Harrison could not do in the 2007 Super Bowl against the New York Giants.
Ralph auditioning for NFL Films again tonight. Though he is correct, and he is an excellent Patriots historian here. As the Broncos here back in shotgun. Good protection for Bradshaw. He's able to fire that one to the sidelines. That pass is going to be complete. Another pass complete to number 21. That's Anthony Ferrillo, the senior wide receiver who is already having himself a heck of a ball game tonight.
Yeah, I've noticed Dave Ferrillo's been really good on those comeback routes there. Really dependable coming back to the football, but then also really quick with his turn back upfield.
Gain of 10 yards. Excellent route running skills being displayed there.
First and 10 Broncos from the Tomahawk 41-yard line.
Alvirne back to pass here, being flushed out. No gain right there as Bradshaw tried to escape. That's number 58. That is Jason Duke, the junior, bringing him down before he could escape.
Ooh, Dave, do we have a new nickname maybe? The Duke?
The Duke?
Ooh,
yes. We might. Over our time proudly doing these broadcasts, we've had the Sarge, we've had the Lieutenant, Everyday Shea. Maybe we have the Duke.
Excuse me, from the Tomahawks 44-yard line.
3 minutes left here in the second quarter. Alvirne into plus territory here. Bradshaw drops back to Pats. Blitz on its way. Fires a bomb way downfield.
Bradshaw's pass intended for Ferrullo.
That pass will be incomplete.
Bring up third and 13 for the Broncos.
Third down, 13 yards here. Big third down here for the Alvirne Broncos. Big third down for the Merrimack Tomahawks defense here. As if they're able to get off the field, they're going to have plenty of time left.
Hey, Dave, it's early still in the game. We're not quite yet to halftime. But we do know Alvirne gets the ball to start the second half. But if Merrimack puts a stop here and gets another drive going and maybe puts some more points on the board, could be a real momentum shift in the game that's been really tightly contested.
Could be here. Bradshaw rolling out to his left. The Merrimack rush has certainly picked up here as he heaves one. That ball is going to fall incomplete.
Bradshaw flushed out of the pocket. Pass
Logan incomplete. Day, though, did make a nice sideline catch. But not in bounds, so that is not a turnover. And it will be fourth down and 13 yards here for the Broncos. As they will send the punting team out here. Punt the ball back to Merrimack here. 2:43 here left in the game. That might as well be an eternity the way things have gone thus far. Both teams exhibiting some quick strike offenses here. Kick is away. It's fielded by the ever dangerous Shea Goodwin trying to take that one upfield. Good stiff arm right there. And Merrimack will take over here on downs.
Goodwin on the return.
2:34 left here in the second quarter. Ralph, you have to figure the whole playbook's open for the Merrimack Tomahawks. Plenty of time left. They'll be able to get some great gains from Hyde up the middle. Crampton has done a great job in the vertical game connecting with Shea Goodwin. The world is their oyster here.
Yeah, Dave, I completely agree. You've got the whole playbook open here, but I might take a shot again. I might see if you can make another big play, catch Alvirne here a little bit on the shift of momentum.
Goodwin here surveying the field, back in shotgun, has Hyde in the backfield with him. And that pass is going to be picked off by the Alvirne Broncos. That is number 19, Andrew Harmon, the sophomore.
Dave, really incredible turn of a change of events there. You're looking at the chance for Merrimack to maybe flip the script a little bit, take a little bit control of the game here, and Alvirne has just done what has happened this entire game, and that's seen both teams kind of battle back and bounce back. Mr. Harmon, there was actually the man who was on the wrong side of the stiff arm on that kick return, comes back and says, "No siree, Bob," and takes it to the house.
Steps right in front of that pass right there. A tough break for Crampton, a rare interception for the senior quarterback here. As Alvirne will kick this one, it is up and it is good. And they will pull ahead of the Merrimack Tomahawks 21-20 here with 2:26 left in what has been a very eventful second quarter. We've seen pick sixes. We have seen kickoffs return for touchdowns. We have seen muff punts. We have seen it all. Some deep touchdown strikes, too, by both quarterbacks. And a rare miscue right there for Kyle Crampton.
Dave, I think my favorite thing to see in a game like this is there's been opportunities for one team or the other to try and take control of the reins, but you've seen both teams fight back and not allow that to happen. So you've got two teams of high character, well coached, that just refuse to quit no matter how many points they might fall behind by, leading to these multiple lead changes this quarter.
Absolutely. It is a testament to the coaching on both sides of the football here and these amazing student athletes. They have the mental fortitude and the preparation here to bounce back from the inevitable mistakes and miscues that are going to happen during a football game, regardless of what level you're playing on.
Done on the return.
As after the interception return for a touchdown, Merrimack gets ready to take over again here on offense. Unfortunate miscue there by the senior quarterback, Kyle Crampton, a rare one at that.
As you said, though, plenty of time to go here in the quarter and a chance to maybe take the lead before heading into the half.
Going back to his very reliable running back here, that's Romello Hyde. He's going to take that one right up the middle, and he's still moving. My goodness gracious.
Silly me, I had been wondering why they maybe didn't blow the whistle dead for a lack of forward motion. Well, that's why, because it's Romello Hyde, and he got another 4 or 5 yards there.
You cannot hope to stop Romello Hyde. With just 4 or 5 tacklers, you may need all 11 right there, as he just demonstrated with a really nice run right there, keeping his legs moving and continuing to pick up positive, tough yardage right there. Great run by Hyde. As he'll go to the sideline here, Goodwin back in the shotgun, Connor Dunn. Crampton's going to take off himself, showing his wheels as well. It's a flag down on the play. We'll see if this one's coming back.
Dave, it looks like we might have a block in the back there on that play, or perhaps a hold. But it looked like that flag came in right where it looked like that was occurring.
We'll have to see what the referee's decision is on this one, but that seems like a pretty good assessment based on where that flag was thrown. And that penalty is against Merrimack.
Illegal contact penalty assessed against the Tomahawks.
And it's going to be an illegal contact penalty. Tough break right there on what was a very nice run by Crampton. Again, he is a terrific athlete. He can get it done through the air and with his legs.
Yeah, he made something out of a little bit of nothing there. The defensive unit there from Alvirne really got in there, putting a lot of pressure, and the line gave him just enough light there to get out there and try to make a play. Unfortunately, just a little miscue there, but still plenty of time here for this offense to make a stand.
Things can certainly happen in the open field here. Minute 34 here, Crampton going back in the shotgun, joined again with the standout running back, Romello Hyde. And he's going to give Hyde the football. Hyde continuing to pick up yards after contact right there. As it looked like for a moment, he might be bottled up at the line of scrimmage, but he's able to explode forward for a nice gain. As the clock continues to tick here on what has been a fantastic game thus far. Crampton again back in shotgun. Looking left, looking to escape. Nice move right there. Another flag goes down. Could potentially be a hold or another illegal contact penalty here. And this ball is going to be going the wrong direction for Tomahawks Nation.
Yeah, 10-yard holding penalty there. Tough break. Let's see what happens here again. Still a minute left to go in the quarter.
Second and 14. Crampton back in the shotgun here with the clock ticking, under a minute left. Takes the snap, looks to his right. He fires. Pass complete to Shea Goodwin. Goodwin making some nice moves right there to bring that down inside the Broncos' 35-yard line.
A little change there in the route. Something across the middle there. Gives them quite a bit of yardage, and then a nice play here to stop the clock from Kyle Crampton.
Still plenty of time left here in the second quarter.
Second and 10 Tomahawks from the
and with the way these
32.
Two teams can score, they could get three touchdowns in 42 seconds, the way this game's been going. As Crampton takes a snap. Good rush by Alvirne. Crampton trying to escape. Almost does, but the D-line for Alvirne able to converge on him
Crampton
and
on
stop it.
Tackled by Toomey and company.
Stop that play before he could take off into the open field here.
No gain on the play. Timeout, Tomahawks.
Timeout, Tomahawks. The town of Merrimack's media division is branded Merrimack TV. The division is funded by way of franchise fees from Comcast cable subscribers in Merrimack. The town of Merrimack has a community TV facility located at 6 Babusick Lake Road. Our three cable channels reach over 8,000 homes, and we're accessible online at MerrimackTV.com and on Roku, Amazon Fire, and Apple TV devices via Cablecast ScreenWeave. So download that Cablecast ScreenWeave app so you can watch the next game live on the big screen. And we know the Tomahawks Nation always joins us throughout the country. Folks watching in their garage, their basement, they got good snacks going, they got it up on the big screen TV. So we always appreciate the passionate diehards of Merrimack Tomahawks Nation and give a sincere thank you to all friends and family of Merrimack Football and Merrimack High School that are supporting these fine student athletes from all across the country here. As the Tomahawks getting ready to come back out here, third down, 10 yards to go, 33 seconds left in a one-point game, what has been a very, very exciting first half. Spread formation for Crampton, he's got a man in motion. Crampton takes the snap, protection is good. Crampton lets this one go, looking for Goodwin again, third time's a charm, but unfortunately that ball is gonna fall incomplete. Trying to force that one into double coverage, well covered right there by Alvirne. You got to figure, though, if you're going to take a shot with anybody in the double coverage, you're throwing that ball to Shea Goodwin.
100% there. And it's interesting here, you've got Merrimack staying on the field here on 4th and 10. And I actually really like this call. I think they have a shot to score, and if you don't, you trust your defense enough to keep Alvirne from scoring in 27 seconds.
Good aggressive call here, a little too close for a field goal. Pardon me, a little too far away for a field goal, a little too close for a punt. So Merrimack here on 4th and 10. Takes the snap, rolls out to his left. Crampton's going to take off here. Can he get it? That one's going to be close. Let's see where they spot it. And it looks like the chain game is moving, so this is going to be a Merrimack first down. Crampton able to get out of bounds here, which will stop the clock.
It's a big first down pickup there. 21 seconds to go, and first and goal. First and 10.
Huge first down here for Merrimack. Merrimack did receive to start the first half, so they will be kicking away to start the second. Hand off to Hyde here. He's going to plow that one forward for a good game.
Hyde on the carry.
As the clock will stop here, 15 seconds left. We'll see what Coach Kip Jackson has in mind here for his offense. With 15 seconds left, knocking on the doorstep of the Broncos end zone here. Ball's on the 16. All right here. 15 seconds left. Ball on the 16-yard line. In what has been a very exciting second quarter. A lot of action. Long touchdown passes, pick sixes, kickoff returns for touchdowns. We've seen it all. Onside kick recoveries.
We still got another full half to play. Jeez.
Pretty unbelievable. Crampton feeling the rush. He's able to get rid of that one, and he's able to almost complete that pass to Shea Goodwin. Amazing effort for Crampton just to get rid of that ball. Goodwin catching that with coverage draped all over him, but unfortunately just couldn't quite come up with it. Can't fault Goodwin for that one, especially given the effort that he has put forth tonight.
Yeah, it was a good pass. It's just tough to handle when you got a defender draped all over you in that area and making a good defensive play as well. I believe he got a little bit of a hand on that, so it just makes it a tough catch.
Tough catch indeed. Looks like the Broncos are starting to shade their coverage in Goodwin's direction. Can't say I blame them for that here. Crampton taking the snap. Blitz is underway. Crampton trying to escape. And that is going to do it here, it looks like, for our first half of play as Crampton is going to be stopped.
Crampton on the keeper.
As time runs out. Trying to call a timeout here, but I think they're going to call the half. Let's see if he was able to get that time off out before the end of the half. It looks like he might have been able to.
Looks like he's getting the timeout call here, and they're putting, I think, 2 seconds on the clock.
Great job right there by Crampton to bring them within field goal range. It's a big moment right here, as this would give Merrimack a 23-21 lead. As it appears that Alvirne may have called a timeout.
Ooh, looking to try to freeze the kicker here.
I often wondered if trying to freeze the kicker actually really did anything.
No matter what the score.
It's a really interesting concept to me. I think about it, and you see those times where in the pros, you'll see the kicker still go through and kind of get that extra opportunity. Does that help? Does it hurt? When they miss it, is it in their head? It's a fascinating play on the psyche. But I think here, when you're looking at something that at this age, you also know you're playing a game. So you think about it in a fun, kind of exciting way that you're just out there to do your job, right?
Absolutely. As this is Matthew Schmidt getting ready to kick it away here, the sophomore. Hold is down, kick is away, and that kick is good. Splitting the uprights, nicely done right there as Merrimack is going to pull ahead here as time expires in the first half. As it'll be the Merrimack Tomahawks 23, the Broncos of Alvirne High School here 21. Amazing first half, Ralph. I hate to sound like a broken record here, but we really saw just about everything you would look for in a football game you've been able to see tonight. I think the only thing we haven't seen are really a strip sack or anything like that, but otherwise I think we've seen it all. We've seen onside kick recoveries. We've seen kickoff returns for touchdowns. We've seen long touchdown passes. We've seen some great handoffs and runs up the middle, great open field play. We've seen it all here.
Yeah, Dave, I don't want to sound like a broken record, but I think we've seen it all tonight.
We certainly have.
Yeah, it's been a pretty exciting first half. It's really hard to find anything there that isn't an amazing view of athleticism here from these student athletes. You had a quarter where no points were scored to start the game, and the combined total is 44 points in that second quarter.
44 points in the second quarter here. Pretty amazing stuff here. It just shows you how explosive both of these teams really are.
Yeah, I don't even know if the Patriots have scored 44 points total this year.
I don't think they have, Ralph. Merrimack High School. We'll have to go back and do some math. Maybe Justin Slez will become our in-studio statistician.
Can someone grab the abacus, please?
With that said, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be presenting an amazing halftime show as the Merrimack Marching Band prepares to take the field, led by the one and the only Marching Band Director Patricia Cunningham. So Ralph and I will see you at the start of the second half. In the meantime, enjoy the festivities here on Senior Night at Merrimack High School. Thank you.
Color guard captains are Ariel DeVitro, Jacob Lynn, and Olivia Sorensen. Tomorrow, the band will be playing for thousands of spectators at the Salem Band Show. The band would especially like to welcome members of the Merrimack Middle School Band, directed by Holly Levine. We eagerly look forward to the day when you join our band family. Ladies and gentlemen, the Merrimack High School Marching Band.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has officially left the building. Tonight's football game is a part of the New Hampshire Tackles Hunger Initiative, sponsored by the New Hampshire Food Bank, WMUR, the NHIAA, and supported by Merrimack High School, Nashua High School South, and many other schools across the state. The food collected at tonight's game will go to support Meals on Wheels of Hillsborough County, also known as St. Joseph's Community Services. St. Joseph's Community Services is the only provider of Meals on Wheels in Hillsborough County. Each week, Meals on Wheels provides about 7,300 nutritious meals to homebound older and disabled adults throughout Hillsborough County. Drivers provide a friendly visit, social connection, and a wellness check. Meals are delivered via 67 routes, originating from one of seven core nutrition sites located throughout the county. This program is so much more than a daily meal. For the majority of these older and disabled Meals on Wheels participants, clients, the driver who delivers the meal is the only person they will see that day, and for 60% of them, the driver is the only person they will see all week. Last year, Meals on Wheels of Hillsborough County provided over 390,655 meals in all nutrition programs. In addition to delivering Meals on Wheels, the agency also offers a community dining program at several of its nutrition sites. This is open to adults ages 60 and older who seek access to nutritious and affordable food, opportunities to socialize with other older adults. 94% of clients report that Meals on Wheels helps them to stay in their own homes. Over 200 volunteers assist with meal delivery, and many others help with meal preparation and special event assistance. Volunteers are always welcome. Check out Meals on Wheels of Hillsborough County online at www.hcmow.org. Tonight's food collection will provide staple foods for homebound, older, and disabled adults. Your assistance is greatly appreciated. To donate or volunteer, call 603-424-9967 or visit them online again at www.hcmow.org. And thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's 50-50 or Apple will benefit Merrimack cheer. The winning number is a red coupon, number 519483. Once again, it's a red coupon, 519483. If this is your number, bring your coupon up to the booth and we'll give you your money.
I'd like to welcome everybody back here joining us for the second half of the Alvirne Broncos versus your Merrimack Tomahawks. Merrimack ahead here 23-21 after what was a very exciting first half. So thank you for joining us here in the second half. I'm joined, as always, by Ralph Carpentier here on color commentary, joining me on the broadcast. Ralph, heck of a first half. We saw it all.
It was a tale of two quarters, really. You had a first quarter where both teams possessed the ball a single time. Merrimack receiving the kick, driving the ball pretty deep into Alvirne territory, getting stopped on fourth down inside.
Fourth and goal.
Yes, fourth and goal inside the 1 yard line. Alvirne takes over, drives the entire distance, 99 plus yards into the end zone, which doesn't culminate until that start of the second quarter, and leads a barrage of points. We had no points in the first quarter and 44 total with this 23-21 lead for Merrimack.
44 combined points in the first half, all coming in what was a very exciting second quarter. It featured some long touchdown passes from Crampton to Shea Goodwin. Jacob Bradshaw was able to complete a long touchdown pass. There was a kickoff return for a touchdown. There was all types of action happening all over the field. We had a pick six, and then Merrimack, of course, guided by senior quarterback Kyle Crampton, able to drive down the field and kick a field goal as time expired on the first half to put Merrimack ahead here by 2 points, 23-21. What do you expect to see here in the second half, Ralph?
Yeah, Dave, honestly, I don't know. I mentioned earlier the comparison to that Super Bowl 38 between the Carolina Panthers and New England Patriots. Both teams started out kind of prodding and probing each other for a chance to kind of see where they could attack, and then exploded in the second quarter, which is kind of what we saw in our first half. Do we see a similar start to the third quarter here and an explosion of points in the fourth? Do we just see a continuation of explosion of points? Or do both teams just clamp down on each other? I couldn't tell you right now.
At this point, I think anything is possible, as this has been a wild game thus far. And
shout out Kevin Garnett for that one.
Shout out to Kevin Garnett, indeed. This has been a wild game thus far and quite a bit of fun here under the lights here at Merrimack High School, as Merrimack getting ready to kick off here to begin the second half.
Goodwin on to kick.
As Shea Goodwin here will kick it off. Merrimack has opted for the squib kick and even an onside kick, which they were able to recover at one point. And Goodwin's going to squib that one. And Alvirne is going to fall on that ball just past their own 25-yard line, I believe. And they will get ready to go to work here on offense.
Kickoff recovered by Rybeck.
As Jacob Bradshaw and company, the senior quarterback, leading his team out there here.
Broncos will start from their 29-yard line.
As this ball will officially be marked at the 29-yard line here for the Alvirne Broncos. Decent field position to start their drive.
Yeah, Dave, it's not bad, but I kind of look to think of it, and, you know, I know it's, you know, 9 yards past the 20, but I look at that and I think, you know, those squib kicks work out for both teams when you avoid potentially kicking the ball out of bounds. It really just allows you to get like a solid, known level of starting field position.
Absolutely here. Bradshaw dropping back to pass. He's got him wide open. That ball is complete to number seven. That is Alvin Toomey, who's had himself a heck of a game as well, as I believe he also has a touchdown grab tonight.
Yeah, nice pass there down the seam. Toomey turns around, ball's right on his numbers. Good pitch and catch.
Excellent pitch and catch right there, as Alvirne going right back to work here on offense. Both teams having a fair degree of success moving the ball both on the ground and through the air. Bradshaw here is going to hand it off to number 17. That's Bryant Montgomery, the senior.
Montgomery on the carry.
And that will bring up a second down.
The Duke in on the stop there.
The Duke again in on the stop.
Broncos from the 50.
Of course, that's number 58, Jason Duke, the junior linebacker. Bradshaw back in shotgun here. He has four wide receivers at his disposal, plus Montgomery in the backfield. Bradshaw dropping back to pass. He lets one rip. That pass is going to be complete to number 13. That's Cole Bucknum.
Pushed out of bounds by Day.
Kick
Gain of four on the play.
And Alvirne here with a couple of passes to start the second half. Already moving the ball into Merrimack territory here at 10:45 left in the third quarter.
From the 46.
Bradshaw in shotgun, two tight end set. Takes the snap, fires. He's got a man open. That pass is going to be complete to number 13. That's Cole Bucknum again.
Bucknum on the reception. Pushed out of bounds by Dunn.
Alvin's really had a lot of success today with those little comeback routes there. You know, 8 to 10 yards downfield, coming back, making the catch. Those are typically safe passes, but extremely effective.
Very effective indeed here, as Bradshaw has been accurate with the football all night. A rare play here where Bradshaw is under center. Single back set. Three wide receivers and a tight end. And on the stretch play, he's going to hand off here. That's number 17. That's Bryant Montgomery. Montgomery, a solid gain there. Second down, 4 yards to go here as Alvirne, starting off the second half, charging down the field, already deep into Merrimack territory here, knocking on the door of the red zone and perhaps the end zone. As time will tell, as Bradshaw back in the pistol formation, he's got Montgomery behind him. Bradshaw takes a snap, handoff to Montgomery.
Dave, you had mentioned the propensity for the teams to be playing out of the shotgun, and you don't see a lot of, you know, handoffs from under center there. It just shows you how prepared these teams are, because that's not an easy exchange between a center and a quarterback, especially if it's not your primary focus when it comes to your offense. And both teams do typically operate outside of the shotgun. I remember being in fifth grade, we had an entire game where the quarterback fumbled the entire game because he had never taken a snap until that game because he came in for an injured player. And it shows you how important it is to practice that every game.
Ralph, that is quite a memory of fifth grade football, as the handoff there goes for a short gain.
Montgomery on the carry.
Montgomery here looks slow to get up on the play. Hopefully he is okay.
Stop by Crampton, but we have an injury timeout for a Bronco.
As this is going to bring about an injury timeout here. As the trainers head out to assist Bryant Montgomery, who's down after that tackle. 9 minutes, 9 seconds left here in the third quarter of what has been a barn burner of a game here. Alvirne taking the kickoff in the second half, to start the second half, rather. Right now in the middle of the sustained drive, which has seen Bradshaw connect with a few of his receivers. Cole Bucknum being the favored target on this drive for a few nice chunk plays, as Bryant Montgomery is able to get off the field and walk off under his own power. We hope he's okay.
Dave, yeah, we're seeing more of a continuation of the first quarter here. A sustained drive of almost 3 minutes now, the first drive of the quarter. So right now we're leaning towards maybe a closer situation.
Maybe slowing down the pace
potentially.
Just a bit here. Bradshaw's got two tight ends, two wide, and a running back in the shotgun. He's going to drop back. They're opting to max protect. He's going to throw that one up there. And Merrimack is going to pick that ball off. That pass picked off by number 20. That's Aiden Centrella, the sophomore, making a nice adjustment on the ball right there. Now both quarterbacks, each with an interception tonight, as this has been a very evenly matched game.
Who was the intended receiver on that play?
Dave, this sudden change is where I might take a shot quickly just to see what Alvirne's got after, you know, a tough break there. Turnovers happen. It's part of the game. But these are those sudden change situations where you maybe want to see if you can attack the other team.
Tomahawks will start from their 20-yard line.
Absolutely, here is, you have to figure, senior quarterback Kyle Crampton and company looking to take advantage of that misstep by the Alvirne Broncos. Crampton takes a snap. He hands off to Romello Hyde. Again, carrying would-be tacklers on his back. Power running game being very effective for Merrimack in this ball game. 6 yard gain right there. Crampton's got a man in motion, fakes a jet sweep, hands off to Hyde. Hyde's gonna find a little bit of daylight right there. A nice gain.
Hyde on the carry.
Should be enough to pick up a Merrimack Tomahawks first down.
Gain of 6 on that play. First and 10, Tomahawks.
6 yard gain officially for Ramelo Hyde. Crampton takes a snap, opting to keep it on the ground with Hyde. Hyde is having himself a heck of a ball game right there, able to pound that one right up the middle into the teeth and the heart of the Alvirne Broncos defense for a really, really nice game. As that is going to be another Tomahawks first down here as they move the ball slowly but surely towards midfield.
I'd really like to see the growth of Hyde from last year to this year. Ramelo is only a junior, and last year as a sophomore, he was a very shorthanded up back on kickoff returns, and now a featured halfback for this team.
Having himself a heck of a season. Speaking of players having themselves a heck of a season, that's another pass complete to the standout, Shea Goodwin. He's going to catch that comeback route and bring that back up the field for a nice gain. Crampton firing a laser in there. Good little pitch and catch right there as Merrimack putting together a bit of a drive here in the third quarter.
Laser was always my favorite of the American Gladiators.
American Gladiators reference. I did not expect that tonight.
I liked that game where they shot the tennis balls out at the contestants. I don't really understand the purpose of that in any way, but...
to hurt people.
Fair.
That's it. You're just really trying to leave bruises at that point.
But Laser, really good hair, too.
For those unfamiliar with American Gladiators, it was a reality television game show in the early 90s where they took really average people like Ralph and I and had them compete against athletes that were far superior in events that were really solely intended to inflict pain on the participants.
Yeah, and all in hopes of laughs, I think, for the audience.
There was Laser, there was Turbo. They all had names like Blizzard, I think, was a
Blazer.
Blazer.
I think Crampton just caught his own pass there.
Looks like Crampton may have caught his own pass. Tough to tell what happened there, but amazing feat of athleticism nonetheless is able to bring that ball up the left sideline. They're going to give him a 1 yard gain on that play here.
Reminded me a little bit of that Marcus Mariota play a few years back, back when he was in Tennessee.
Crampton here dropping back to pass. That ball is going to fall incomplete here.
Crampton's pass intended for Goodwin falls incomplete. We'll bring up third down. Tomahawks.
Are you enjoying the action of tonight's game? Well, then check out more MHS sports action for Merrimack TV on your Roku, Amazon Fire TV, or Apple TV device. Download Cablecast ScreenWeave to watch the next game live on the big screen. This is Merrimack TV, your community, your voice, and we thank you for joining us tonight in what has been a terrific ball game thus far. Crampton rolling out to his left. He's going to throw that one down to Hyde on a little screen pass. He's got some blockers out in front of him. There goes the convoy. Hyde able to utilize that speed and that power to chug up field for some good yardage.
Screen Weaver. Was that... that's my favorite Gary Wright song, I believe, right?
Ralph, I'm not sure.
Oh, that's Dream Weaver.
Dream Weaver. Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Kyle Crampton taking that snap, trying to push it forward. Looks like he might have put that ball on the ground. Does Alvirne have it? He may have been down by contact. We'll see.
Where are the Surface tablets when you need them?
I'm still thinking about the screen weaver comment you just made. That was a world-class dad joke, Ralph.
I was going to sing it instead, but I didn't know if I had the copyright to do that or if it was a fair use.
And that ball, unfortunately for Merrimack, is going to fall just short here, and they are going to be unable to pick up the first down. And here comes the Alvirne Broncos offense. Kyle Crampton doing everything he possibly could there to try to pick up that first down. But unfortunately, it's just a few inches short here as the Alvirne Broncos are going to get set to take over here. Second turnover on downs for Merrimack. Let's see what Alvirne can do here in terms of being able to capitalize on a really nice defensive stand right there. As Jacob Bradshaw and company come back out here in first and 10 from their own 31-yard line. Handoff again right there to number 17. That's Bryant Montgomery. Opting to bring a fullback in on that play too. Number 40, Joseph Ryback, the junior, also lining up in the backfield there, providing some lead blocking assistance. Bit of a convoy there for Bryant Montgomery. Second and seven. Merrimack defense able to stop that for a gain of 3 yards here, as it'll be second and seven for the Alvirne Broncos. Two tight end set again here for Alvirne. And another handoff right there to Montgomery. And the Merrimack defense is going to swallow that one up in the backfield.
Allard stopped in the backfield by Crampton.
Good play right there by the Merrimack defense here. As this third quarter feels like it is flying by in a blink of an eye here.
Yeah, very, very reminiscent of that first quarter of this game.
And here come the Broncos up here, third and seven. Let's see what they do. Sending a man in motion right here. Bradshaw taking the snap, rolling out to his right. He fires. That pass is going to fall incomplete.
Bradshaw's pass intended for Fay.
Looks like it was intended for number 20. That's the sophomore Colin Fay. And the Broncos here are likely going to send out their special teams unit to kick this one away on fourth and seven. Bit too deep in their own territory to take a shot here.
Bit too deep, a little long in terms of the yardage to go. Merrimack going to get their second chance to possess the ball here.
Snap is away, the kick is up. Good high, deep kick here. That ball is going to fly out of bounds. And Kyle Crampton and company will get ready to take over again on offense. Looking to protect that two-point lead. If this game has taught us anything tonight, Ralph, it's that no lead is safe. Been quite a back and forth here from both of these teams. Very evenly matched, very competitive game thus far. With 4:13 here left in the third quarter.
Yeah, Dave, the only argument I'd make there is the lead that happens when this clock hits zero would probably be safe. But that's the only one.
I would agree with you there, Ralph. That would signify the end of the game here is Kyle Crampton looking to get away from everybody. Another flag, though, down on the play at right about the Broncos' 48-yard line, we'll call it here. This one might be coming back. Looks like it was a holding call here on Merrimack. That is the second or third one of those long Kyle Crampton runs that has been called back. Tough break there.
Yeah, I think on the first two, you had a lineman looking to keep his quarterback upright and safe. On that one, you know, just getting a little aggressive outside as that play continued.
Crampton again, handing it off to who else? Raymelo Hyde, but the Broncos defense here all over that one. Stopping him behind the line of scrimmage. A rare carry that does not go for positive yardage here for Raymelo Hyde. Nice display of sportsmanship right there. as he picks up number 7, Alvin Toomey, senior D lineman and tight end receiver. For the Alvirne Broncos here is Crampton back in shotgun again in their traditional spread formation, Hyde in the backfield. Crampton with that hard snap count all night trying to draw the Broncos D lineman offsides. High snap, Crampton's able to bring that one down. Broncos pass rush there ferocious as they are able to get into the backfield and bring Crampton down for a loss. Both defenses here looking strong to start the third quarter. You would ask the question, Ralph, are we going to see more offensive fireworks or are we going to see these defenses make some adjustments at the half? And it appears that they may have made some adjustments here at the half.
Yeah, certainly looks like that, Dave. It appears that both teams have kind of settled back into the feel that they had early in the game.
Crampton back in shotgun, 4 wide receivers, Hyde in the backfield with him. Alvirne showing blitz. Alvirne's going to back off here. They're only going to rush 3. Crampton fires, and that ball is going to fall incomplete. Pass intended for number 2, Shea Goodwin.
Crampton's pass intended for Goodwin, broken up by Ferrullo.
As both defenses here are tightening up and getting a little bit more stingy with the amount of yardage that they're willing to concede to the opponent offense.
Dufour on to receive.
As Merrimack gets ready to punt this one away with 2:28 here left in the third quarter. In case you were just joining us, this has been a heck of a game thus far. With Merrimack taking the opening drive all the way down to the Alvirne 1. They were unable to convert on 4th and goal. Alvirne taking over on what amounted to their half yard line. Drove 99 yards downfield, taking the entire first quarter and into the second quarter to put up the first points of the game. And then from there, the fireworks started. Immediately, Merrimack answers back with a kickoff return for a touchdown. Alvirne able to complete some long passes for touchdowns. Merrimack able to answer back, doing the exact same thing. Kyle Crampton throws a pick 6 towards the end of the second half that gave Alvirne their third touchdown. And then Merrimack able to take the kickoff after that pick 6, drive the ball nearly the length of the field, put themselves comfortably in field goal range, thanks in large part to Kyle Crampton's arm and his legs, which has brought us to this 23-21 score that we see thus far. Each team with a turnover. Very, very evenly matched here. As the snap is away, Merrimack able to line drive kick right here, able to get that one away. That is going to take a very favorable Merrimack bounce here deep into Alvirne high school territory here, and the Broncos are going to have their work cut out for them as they're going to be starting from what appears to be their own, we'll call it 7-yard line, most certainly inside their own 10. Nice kick right there by Merrimack. Again, special teams, the name of the game tonight, can win you games and it can lose you games.
Absolutely, Dave. That is just showing this quarter has been absolutely all about field position, and it'll be interesting to see whose counterpunch will lead to the first points of the second half.
No question there. As we had mentioned earlier in the quarter, 44 combined points in the second quarter of this game. So when the scoring has started, it's come in bursts, but this third quarter has been quiet thus far, as each defense really doing a great job here. Bradshaw is going to keep that one himself, pounding it right up the guts of the defense right there for some real tough running and yardage.
Bradshaw on the quarterback keeper.
Good keeper right there by Bradshaw.
Stopped by the entire.
Interested in learning more about Merrimack TV? Would you like your own TV show on the community channel? Well, email Nicholas and Justin, MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov.
Second and one.
As it's going to be second and one here, under a minute 40 left here in the third quarter. Both defenses here really tightening up, showing the adjustments that each head coach made and defensive teams made at the half to slow down some of the scoring here. Bradshaw and another keeper. Good run right here. He's going to find some daylight, able to push that one up towards midfield, up to the Broncos' 34-yard line, it looks like. Nice run right there.
Yeah, Dave, the quarterback's had some really key runs four first downs here for Alvirne, both on this drive and in previous drives. He's also been able to get it done a bit with the arm and the leg today.
No question about it. Under a minute remaining here in the third quarter. Handoff there to number 25. That's Eric Allard, his first carry of the game right there. Merrimack defense quick with the carry to stop that one. As time continues to tick down here on the third quarter of what has been an extraordinarily good matchup here between two teams that are solid in all three phases of the game here, including some terrific quarterback play on both sides of the ball. Bradshaw again back in shotgun. He's going to step back to pass here. Fires and completes it to number 13. That's Cole Bucknam. That's got to be at least his fourth or fifth catch of the game right there, as he's able to catch that one and churn up field for some good yardage, as that will conclude the third quarter of play here at Merrimack High School with your Tomahawks leading the Broncos of Alvirne High School 23-21 as we get ready here for the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Dave, I'm really curious to see how the fourth quarter plays out. We now have had both halves start out with some more methodical, conservative, probing style offensive play and some really suffocating defense on both sides. That second quarter, really the anomaly so far, where they kind of exploded on both sides for 44 total points that have led us to this 23-21 lead for Merrimack. Does the fourth quarter look like the second quarter, or are we going to see a continuation of the third? I guess we'll have to watch and find out.
Absolutely. That is why they play the game, folks. The town of Merrimack's media division is branded Merrimack TV. The division is funded by way of franchise fees from Comcast cable subscribers in Merrimack. The town of Merrimack has a community TV facility located at 6 Babusick Lake Road. Our three cable channels reach over 8,000 homes. We're accessible online at MerrimackTV.com and on Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, and Apple TV devices via Cablecast ScreenWeave. So stay informed, follow Merrimack TV on social media, and subscribe to Merrimack TV on YouTube. Thank you for watching Merrimack TV, your community, your voice. And we certainly do thank you for joining us tonight, as this has been a heck of a game. As we get ready here to start the fourth quarter. First and 15. As the Alvirne Broncos here down two here at the start of the fourth quarter to the Merrimack Tomahawks here. Single back set here, three wide receivers, one tight end. Stretch handoff right here. Relatively short gain right there on the handoff to number 25. That's the senior, Eric Allard. On the carry, brought down by Duke.
Gain of three on the play. The Duke in on the tackle yet again.
The Duke having himself a heck of a game tonight. That's number 58, Jason Duke, the junior.
The Duke, Dukes of Hazzard. Bring up second and 12. That's all I got so far.
Two tight ends set here for the Alvirne Broncos. Bradshaw takes a snap. Well protected, able to fire downfield. That pass is going to fall incomplete. Looks like there may have been either a miscommunication there or that ball was overthrown. Bring up third and 12. Third and 12 here. Favorable situation for the Merrimack defense. The 45. As they're going to be looking to get off the field here on this third down. Alvirne Broncos, meanwhile, perhaps going to be looking to go back to that vertical passing game that they had so much success with in the first half. Throwing some of those taller receivers that they have out on the perimeter, perhaps senior quarterback Jacob Bradshaw is going to look to take advantage of that. Alvirne here back in the shotgun. Two tight end set, two wide receivers, one running back. Bradshaw being flushed out. And he is going to be brought down, it looks like.
Bradshaw sacked.
He is, in fact, sacked right there. That sack, number 18, Dominic Helmig, the junior linebacker, able to get into the backfield and bring Jacob Bradshaw down for a sack.
Great play by the junior linebacker there, flushing Bradshaw out of the pocket and taking care of business on his own there.
No question about it there is the Merrimack defensive line here has really come alive here in the second half. As Alvirne's going to be forced to punt here, that is going to have a major impact on field position. Goodwin able to field that punt cleanly. Running out to his left, he's got some daylight here. Goodwin very dangerous in the open field. He's already got some kickoff returns for touchdowns earlier this season against Nashua North, and again with a really nice punt return right there.
Speaking of taking care of business, something that Shea Goodwin does pretty much on all aspects of the game, and anytime he really touches the ball, it's also an amazing Bachman Turner overdraft song.
You've been Ralph Pinfield, and this is 120 minutes. For anyone out there that's an old fan of MTV shows, you know what 120 minutes is. If you were born anytime after, let's say, 1985, you probably have no idea what that television show is. But nonetheless, Ralph, a music historian as well as an NFL historian and a lover of fine football snacks here. As Merrimack, after the really nice punt return there by Shea Goodwin, taking over with some excellent field position here deep into Broncos territory, ball on their 32-yard line, the Alvirne 32 to be exact here, as that handoff goes to number 20, that is Aiden Centrella. The sophomore with a nice run right there.
Centrella, the ball carrier, brought down by Harmon.
Hey, Dave, it looks like with Montgomery out right now, I think likely due to getting banged up earlier in the third quarter, hopefully he is okay. We're seeing a mix of players deployed at that halfback position.
You're also potentially seeing some attrition set in here as this game has been a back-and-forth battle as Alvirne blitzes. Crampton able to get rid of the ball. He's got single coverage. He had Goodwin again. Goodwin, unfortunately, unable to come up at that one. Excellent coverage there nonetheless. That was number 21, Anthony Ferrello, who has also had himself a heck of a game on offense as well. Covering Goodwin. Just couldn't quite come up with it right there. But you have to figure with the amount of back and forth that we've seen in this game and long sustained drives, you know, and the fact that so many of these players play both on offense and defense, that's a lot of snaps to take in during a game. So no surprise here that both teams are mixing it up, trying to bring in some other players here, not only to get them experience, but also to give some of their starters a rest. As Crampton here is just going to keep this one, taking off right, plenty of room. He's going to be dragged down just outside the red zone. That should be good enough here for a Merrimack first down, and it is. Crampton again showing off that athleticism, the senior quarterback, having himself a heck of a season. It cannot be overstated what a pleasure it has been watching Kyle play and develop over the last 2 years. Really has become a terrific quarterback. As that handoff here to his terrific running back, that's Raymelo Hyde.
A drag him into the end zone.
The entire Alvirne defense with him right there into the end zone for a Tomahawks touchdown. Raymelo Hyde with a huge touchdown run right there.
Raymelo Hyde playing a little hide and seek with the defense there.
He certainly did. As Merrimack here looks to attempt the point after to pull ahead here by 9. Score now 29-21 Tomahawks. Low snap. They're able to get it down, though. Unfortunately, that kick is going to fall just short. That is going to be no good here. Nonetheless, though, Merrimack pulling ahead here, 29 to Alvirne's 21 on an excellent drive right there. Really getting it done on the ground. Some nice runs on third down by Kyle Crampton, capped off with a power run from Raymelo Hyde, able to carry several defenders with him into the end zone. As Merrimack here taking the lead, an 8-point lead with 9:16 left in the fourth quarter, and what has been a great back-and-forth ball game.
Yeah, Dave, this is the largest lead of the game for either side. This has been a really, really close, hard-fought, tough game. And we talked a little bit about special teams earlier. We've got two mixed extra points thus far for Merrimack, which does keep Alvirne in striking distance and within one possession right now. So what a game we've got on our hands.
Still plenty of time left here, and the Alvirne Broncos have shown an ability to move the football tonight, as Goodwin's going to kick this one. It is going to roll out of bounds. So that's going to give the Broncos some pretty spectacular field position. Did you know that Merrimack TV has committed to live broadcasts of 10 Merrimack High School varsity home games this fall? Check out our sports coverage calendar at merrimacktv.com. If you'd like to see an away game, check out the New Hampshire Coalition for Community Media's network calendar. Our peers in other communities may be covering your away games live on their channels and live streams. Find Merrimack away game coverage at www.nhccm.org/network. And I can tell you, I've been to the NHCCM site, and it is terrific. You can find literally any game going on throughout the state, and if it's being covered somewhere, you should be able to find it and watch a broadcast of it, so you can catch all the amazing sports action for your Merrimack Tomahawks.
Incredible.
Absolutely, here as Shea Goodwin getting set to kick off here again. Another squib kick. That one does hit an Alvirne player, and it's going to take a very, very friendly Merrimack bounce. Merrimack able to recover the kick after what was a very unfortunate bounce right there by Alvirne. Shea Goodwin, I don't know if he intended to do that or not, but what a play on special teams right there, as Merrimack able to come up with that one. Tough, tough break for Alvirne. And Merrimack is going to have some prime time field position as they're going to take over here on their own 45-yard line with 9:15 left in the fourth quarter. Romello Hyde there with another big carry.
First down, Tomahawks.
As Merrimack here is driving, under 9 minutes here left in the fourth quarter. Crampton takes the snap, another handoff to Hyde. Good gang tackling right there by the Alvirne defense, as they're going to prevent
Hyde on the carry
that ball going any further upfield.
Hey, I think here you know that Kip Jackson tends to ride the guys that are producing, and you've seen some great play from Shea Goodwin, but Romello Hyde here has also looked incredible in the backfield.
Absolutely. Having himself a heck of a game and a heck of a season as well here. As it looks like Alvirne's going to take a timeout here with 8:34 left in the game. Don't forget, if you're enjoying tonight's game, make sure you check out more of the MHS sports action for Merrimack TV on your Roku, your Amazon Fire TV, or Apple TV device. Download Cablecast ScreenWeave to watch the next game live on the big screen. This is Merrimack TV, your community, your voice. And of course, we thank you for joining us tonight. We know Tomahawks Nation very well represented from all across the country. We've had fans reaching out to us all throughout the season from as far as Flower Mound, Texas, and Grand Rapids, Michigan, Cocoa Beach, Florida, all over the country. Always great to see friends and family with the ability to tune in here to see your Merrimack Tomahawks. Tomahawks Nation alive and well here as Crampton and company get ready on this 2nd and 8 ball on the Alvirne 42-yard line here. Crampton flushed out to his left. He's going to check down Hyde. Hyde taking that pass. Nice run off that left sideline. Good gain.
Pushed out of bounds by Graham. Gain of 8 on the play.
Romello Hyde showing off the soft hands as he's able to bring that check down pass in for a good gain here, as this is going to make it a 3rd and 1 situation. Alvirne, 8 men in the box here, as they are going to be looking to stuff any run that comes up the middle. Let's see what Kyle Crampton and company come up with here on third and one. They're able to protect Crampton. He's able to complete that pass to a wide open Shea Goodwin. Goodwin able to make a couple of nifty moves right here. He's going to make a run to the end zone. He's going to score a Merrimack Tomahawks touchdown. Shea Goodwin with his third of the ball game right there, as Merrimack will pull ahead 35 to 21 with 8:18 left in the fourth quarter. Great play right there by Kyle Crampton. Merrimack offensive line able to block up the blitz, giving him enough time to deliver that strike to Shea Goodwin, who then is able to catch that pass and with some nifty footwork able to take it all the way to the house for another Tomahawks touchdown.
Absolutely, David. Look there that the defender for Alvirne had his Shea Goodwin in his sights. Goodwin just makes a great play there. He's able to tiptoe his way into the end zone. And we've got the biggest lead thus far of the night, but the way things have gone, Alvirne could strike back just as quick.
You get the feeling tonight that no lead is safe in this game with just the back and forth that we've had. But Merrimack, you have to admit, is beginning to assert some dominance here midway through the fourth quarter, as they now have a 2-touchdown lead over the Alvirne Broncos. Merrimack tonight powered by some outstanding efforts from senior Shea Goodwin. Romello Hyde, the junior running back, also having a great game on the ground. Also caught a key pass on that last drive. And of course, Kyle Crampton finding open receivers all night long, able to avoid the Broncos pass rush and deliver strikes when they have been needed here. As let's see what sort of magic Shea Goodwin has after Merrimack able to recover what would go down as a fumbled onside kick. Again, trying the squib kick. That one's going to be caught cleanly by the Broncos, and they're going to be able to return that one up to their own 45-yard line, we'll call it here, with 8:11 left in the fourth quarter. Also want to take this opportunity, too, to give a huge, sincere thank you to the Merrimack TV staff here, Media Services Coordinator Nicholas LaValle. Tonight in studio with us, the Assistant Media Services Coordinator, the one and only Justin Slez, and of course, operating camera tonight at the game, Media Assistant David McGinnis. Thank you to those folks and to everyone here at Merrimack TV. Always an absolute pleasure to be a part of these broadcasts and have the honor and the privilege to do these broadcasts for you, Tomahawks Nation, watching along at home tonight, as that pass is going to fall incomplete.
Bradshaw's pass intended for Bucknum. Just off his fingertips, second and 10 Broncos.
I also want to take a moment here to shout out the one and only Andy Berkeley, who you hear over the PA announcing system at the game. He's also the voice of Merrimack High Hockey as well. Tremendous volunteer and an overall football guru. As Alvirne with four wide receivers here, Bradshaw rolling out to his left. And that pass is going to fall incomplete, intended for number 84. That is the tight end, Brendan Graham, captain.
Yeah, Merrimack's defense here looking to clamp down a little bit here on Alvirne. It's been a pretty strong defensive struggle in the first and third quarters today. Second was a bit of an offensive explosion. But here in the fourth, Merrimack's been able to convert some points while staying stout defensively.
Absolutely here, Merrimack looking to protect the home field and bring their second win home of the season. Despite the 1-4 record, the Merrimack Tomahawks have been a very exciting team to watch all season long. And with a couple of breaks going a couple of different ways, that record could look distinctly different. This is a good ball club, and they're showing it here tonight with a complete effort in all three phases of the game here. With 8:01 left in the fourth quarter, Alvirne here, third and 10, ball on their own 45-yard line. It's a big third down here for Alvirne. They got a new quarterback in there. That's number 9, Zachary Peters, the junior. That pass is going to be complete, bringing them out towards midfield. And that will bring up fourth down. It does look like the Alvirne offense here is going to stay out here on this fourth down. Fourth and six. Very manageable situation here. Zachary Peters takes the snap out of shotgun, looking down the field. He tosses one, throws it up into coverage. That one looks like it's going to be picked off. Doing it on both sides of the field here. That's number seven, Kyle Crampton, playing center field and coming down with that pass. Nice play right there by the Merrimack defense. Peters throwing that one up there, hoping to make one happen. Unfortunately for him, the Merrimack defense comes away with the interception there with 7:17 left in the ball game here. And things are certainly looking up here for the Tomahawks as they have a 14-point lead here and the ball. After a tough interception right there thrown by the Alvirne Broncos. Can't fault them, though. Down 14 in the fourth quarter. You got to try to make something happen.
Yeah, sometimes you need a little bit of a big play to spark things here, and they got to take their chance. It didn't turn them out the way they wanted there, but there's still time left to go.
And Crampton here back in the shotgun. Pistol formation to be exact. Hide behind him. Crampton decides to keep that. May have lost a yard or two there.
Gobbled up by Graham and company. Loss of three on the play.
And according to the one and only Andy Berkeley, that's a loss of three, so we'll call it second and 13 here. Ball on the Merrimack 26.
From their 26-yard line.
And that play is going to be blown dead. That's going to be a false start on the Merrimack Tomahawks, and that one is coming back here. Illegal procedure penalty.
Second and 20 from their 21-yard line.
At this point, Merrimack really just looking to milk that clock as much as they possibly can here as Crampton takes a high snap. Romello Hyde taking that pass out in the flat, able to bring that down the sideline, making up some of that yardage that they lost.
Crampton's pass complete to Hyde.
After the penalty and the first down play that had gone nowhere here.
Pushed out of bounds by Tobin. Gain of eight on the play.
Called it an 8-yard gain on that play. Ball back on the Merrimack 29-yard line. Back to the original line of scrimmage here as it is 3rd and 10. Crampton in the shotgun, four wide receivers. He steps back to pass. He's going to fire one deep down the field. Goodwin was tripped up on that one, looking for a flag. I don't think he's going to get one.
Crampton's pass intended for Goodwin.
Yeah, tough to throw a flag there. It looks a little bit like incidental contact. Obviously, can understand Shea's frustration there as he has a chance to make a play on that ball if they don't get tangled up. But I think that's a good no call.
Yeah, for sure. But if you're Shea Goodwin, don't you want four touchdowns tonight? I think you do.
I want all the touchdowns.
Absolutely. Can't say you blame him there. As Goodwin comes out here as the long snapper for the punting formation, as Merrimack, with 6:07 left in the game, gets set to kick this one away. Low snap. Just barely able to get that kick away. And Merrimack is going to down this kick. Very, very short kick there. Low snap. Alvirne all over that one. Pressuring that kick.
Down by the Broncos.
And this is where it gets interesting here is the Alvirne Broncos down two touchdowns, but with 5:55 left in what has been a very interesting back and forth game. And some great field position. They are most certainly not out of this one whatsoever.
Yeah, with the way that both teams scored points in the second quarter, we know that both really can pop off at any moment. So it is a big question on who's going to win this game.
Peters with good protection here, rolling out to his left. taking off, showing some speed right here. A nice run as he brings that inside the Merrimack 35-yard line. Good pickup right there. Zachary Peters here, the junior, opting go with the no huddle. Going to take the snap. Able to escape the rush. Running for his life right there. Taking it right up the field, though, for a positive gain. As the clock continues to tick here. Alvirne right back up to the line of scrimmage here. Opting for the no huddle. Can't say you blame them here. As time is ticking away here. Still plenty of time left to make up two scores, but they're going to have to get one here sooner rather than later. As Peters rifles that one incomplete.
Peters' pass intended for Prescott.
Pass was intended for the senior, Colin Prescott, number 10.
Incomplete. Fourth and one.
Bronco. And just like that, it's fourth down, 1 yard to go here. You have to think, if Alvirne's going to have a shot in this game, they're going to have to convert on fourth and one. Peters drops back to pass. He's got some time. He lets one go. That pass fired just in and out of the hands of number 22. That is Cameron Drohan, the sophomore. Nearly able to pick that one up. Recognize the single coverage, just couldn't quite hold on to that one, and Alvirne, unfortunately, will turn it over on downs there as the Tomahawks set to take over here on offense. 4:51 left, a two-touchdown lead, a power running game that has been working in their favor and quite effective all night long. You have to feel pretty good if you're head coach Kip Jackson right now, don't you, Ralph?
Yeah, I would think so. You've got a situation where you've got a solid 14-point lead here. There's under 5 minutes left to go in the game. It's certainly not over by a long stretch, but you know that this is a position that Merrimack wants to be in, with the lead, with the ball, late in the game.
No question about it here as they fake the jet sweep, handoff to Hyde. Hyde taking that one right up the middle. Good strong run right there. Nice show of sportsmanship also by Brendan Graham right there, helping Hyde up off the turf.
Gain of five on the play. Second and five, Tomahawks.
5 yard gain there as the clock continues to wind down on what has been a terrific game tonight. Romello Hyde taking the handoff. That's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Alvirne defense able to bottle that one up. It was number 84 as Brendan Graham again in on the stop, the senior captain.
Gain of a yard on the play. Third and four, Tomahawks.
This will bring up a third and four, maybe four and a half. As I would imagine, Merrimack's going to be content to continue to let this clock run down here. Crampton on the keeper, nowhere to go there. As the Alvirne defense swarming to the ball carrier there.
Loss of two on that play.
Big stand from Alvirne there. It was a play they really had to have. They got it, and we'll see what happens here with just about 3 minutes left by the time they get the ball. Can they complete a comeback?
Yeah, the defense did their job right there. Alvirne's going to need a quick strike and likely some help in special teams if they're going to be able to get back into this one. But stranger things has certainly happened. And this game has had some wild moments, some quick strikes and scores. So we'll see how this one plays out here.
Stranger things. Good show.
Great show.
Not quite as good as the game we've seen tonight, because this has been a classic of epic proportions, but good show nonetheless.
You're certainly correct there, Ralph. It has been a terrific game tonight, and I do enjoy Stranger Things. But where else could I be, or where else would I rather be than here at the Merrimack TV studios, having the privilege to call what has been an amazing game tonight? This has been a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's been amazing. It always has been, and I'm really thankful for the opportunity to call this game and get to watch these student-athletes play every night. I think the only place that would be better is maybe in that stadium itself, like in those stands with those fans listening
and
enjoying the game there. But outside of that, nowhere else I'd rather be.
Merrimack just barely able to get that punt away. And that's going to be fielded by Alvin. Just up past the 35-yard line. Call that the 36. 2:42 here left in the game. Time is of the essence here for Alvin if they're looking to scratch their way back into this one.
No return on the play. Broncos will start.
And what has been a
pretty
crazy second half, if you think about it. It was a quiet third quarter, both teams really dialing it on defense, making some great halftime adjustments. And then Merrimack finally able to answer back with some touchdowns, including recovering a kickoff that bounced off of an Alvirne Broncos player. Tough break for Alvirne, and Merrimack always opportunistic and well coached by Kip Jackson. That pass looks like it's in and out of the hands of number 84. That was Brendan Graham.
Looks like they're going to call it incomplete, but kudos to Graham there. It's one of the reasons he's probably a captain. Getting on that ball, not letting that ball squirt free after putting it on the ground. Excellent, excellent awareness there.
Understood the moment, understood the importance of continuing to possess the football. Very heady play there, even though that was ruled incomplete. Almost made a very nice play there, catching that ball on the sideline in traffic. Certainly not an easy thing to do, but unfortunately was not able to come away with it there. As after that incomplete pass, it'll be second and 10 here on the Alvirne Broncos 36-yard line with 2:34 left in this game. Zach Peters now in at quarterback, takes a low snap, rolls out to his left, looking, firing. And that ball is going to be batted down right there. Good coverage by Merrimack.
Yes, the time ticks down, dude. It looks like we're starting to see Alvirne continue to take some shots down the field, trying to get that first score quickly before looking to maybe recover an onside kick or whatever it might be to sustain a second drive, but really trying to get that ball down the field quickly and efficiently.
Third and 10 here. You have to figure this is four down territory, regardless of what happens on this play for Alvirne. Peters takes the snap, rolls to his left. Good rush on by Merrimack there. That pass is going to fall incomplete.
Peters' pass incomplete.
Nowhere really for Peters to go with the ball there. Good pass rush by the Merrimack defense. To again take a moment and thank the incredible staff here at Merrimack TV. Media assistant David McGinnis on camera tonight, our assistant media services coordinator Justin Slez producing us here back in the studio, and of course media services coordinator Nicholas LaValle. Really an honor to be invited here to be a part of the Merrimack High School community, to be a part of Tomahawks Nation, and I really enjoy the opportunity to volunteer and call the games this season. We hope that you've enjoyed these broadcasts as much as we have had delivering them to you. And we thank you for tuning in tonight and for tuning in all season long here. As we're moving into the closing moments here of a fantastic ball game that has Merrimack ahead of Alvirne 35-21. And here comes Alvirne back out on offense on fourth down.
This is a pivotal play in the game here, Dave.
Looks like Merrimack showing blitz here. Let's see if they follow through, if they back out. They back out into coverage. Decent protection there for Peters. He's going to loft one up. And unfortunately, that pass is going to fall incomplete. Intended for number 21, Anthony Ferrullo. Ferrullo had himself a heck of a ball game. Can't blame Peters for trying to make something happen there and going to Ferrullo downfield. And Merrimack here is going to take over with prime field position.
It was pretty close, Dave, to a completed pitch and catch there on a play they got to have. But Merrimack stands tall again, and we are 2 minutes and 18 seconds away from a Merrimack home victory.
Absolutely here. A hard-fought victory nonetheless. Ball on the 36 here. Crampton out in the spread formation. Romello Hyde taking the handoff. Did he lose the ball there?
Out.
He might have lost the ball.
Crampton on the keeper.
We'll see who recovered this here.
I apologize. It was Hyde on the carry.
A little more life here for Alvirne as we got a second chance here.
And Alvirne able to recover that fumble. .210 left in the game. The clock is still Alvirne's enemy, but they possess the most important thing here, and that's the football, which gives them an opportunity to march downfield and score some points.
Possession is 9/10 of the law, I've heard before. I don't know what that has to do with anything.
I've heard that before, too. I think I heard it on like old WWF wrestling shows back in the early 90s when the bad guy would steal the belt from the good guy. I don't actually
think that's a good reference. I think that might be where we
I don't actually think that's the law, but
I was never good with fractions, so
me neither. Actually, that's not true. I used to teach math. As that pass was intended for Alvin Toomey on the sideline. Pass gonna fall incomplete here with 2:06 left in the fourth quarter of what has been a great ball game here. Alvirne back in the shotgun here. Peters with four wide receivers at his disposal. Merrimack showing blitz, sending blitz. Able to pick up the open receiver right there. That pass is complete. To number seven, that's Alvin Toomey. Who's had himself an excellent game thus far. Both Toomey and Ferrullo have fueled the Alvirne Broncos passing game here thus far. Peters under center here, spikes the ball with a minute 48 left. That's a big play right there for Alvirne.
Yeah, Dave, the way we've seen this game go and the fumble recoveries on the kicks that we've seen as well, Alvirne scores here and we've got a brand new ball game with less than 2 minutes to go.
Merrimack still fully in control with a minute 48 left, but you're right. You know, a quick score here and the way the kicking game is played out tonight, you never know what can happen. Merrimack's had some tough losses this year. Nashua North comes to mind, where at times they look dominant in that game, but Nashua North, last year's state champs, able to come back here. So that's another pass complete going right back to Alvin Toomey. This has been the Alvin Toomey show on this drive as a senior with another big gain right there. Minute 40 left as Peters bringing his offense back up to the line. Peters coming in and playing in relief of Jacob Bradshaw as he's going to down that one.
Looking really good down the seam there on those routes, the bigger receiver to me.
Yeah, looking to exploit the matchups there where Alvirne can take advantage of some of the athleticism that they have on the perimeter.
I find, Dave, at this level, a lot of times size can just be a really big differentiator. The skill level is typically pretty comparable, but sometimes size, it's just kind of the luck of the draw there.
It's tough to teach height, that's for sure here, as Peters back in shotgun. Four wide receivers, one running back there with him. He's looking downfield. He's going to launch one. He's got a man open, and that looks like it was caught.
Big play for Alvirne.
Can't tell
there.
If they gave him the touchdown there or not. And it looks like they did give him the touchdown officially. Couldn't quite see if the referee had signaled it. So Alvirne with a huge score right there as Peter is able to connect on a long touchdown pass, finding the single coverage. And this one is not over yet, folks, as Alvirne able to hammer that extra point home through and capitalizing after the Merrimack fumble. Alvirne suddenly coming to life here with under 2 minutes left in the game, able to drive downfield on a couple of long touchdown throws. Pardon me, a couple of long passes, which resulted in a long touchdown throw from Zachary Peters to an open receiver. Big, big drive right there from Alvirne. And they're within seven, Ralph, with a minute 29 left.
Yeah, did we talked about this. I mean, we've, again, seen a few kickoffs recovered with fumbles there caused from onside kicks. So anything can really happen. We've got that minute 29 left, and as you saw, Alvirne drove down there in under a minute to score there. It's amazing. You think you said it earlier today. It ain't over till it's over.
No, it most certainly is not. It'll be interesting to see what Alvirne does here. Have to imagine it'll be an onside kick. Where they put it, what they try to do with it. Unfortunately, I don't think that onside kick for Alvirne traveled quite far enough here, so Merrimack is going to take over with terrific field position and a minute 29 left.
I think regardless of what happened last time they had the ball, Merrimack is going to feed Ray Mello Hyde here.
Most certainly going to look Romello Hyde's way. Well, surprising all of us, that ball is going back to Shea Goodwin right there. The fake to Hyde. Quick pass out to Goodwin as he's able to pick up some good positive yardage right there, bringing that across midfield.
Gain of 13 on that play.
13-yard pickup right there.
First and 10, Tomahawks from the Bronco 36.
This has been a terrific game tonight. Can't say that I'm surprised that it's sort of come down here to the final minutes as Alvirne able to answer back with a touchdown here in the waning moments of this game. Merrimack now back with the ball. The name of the game for them is to bleed out that remaining 1 minute and 16 seconds. Alvern's going to be desperate to try to force a turnover here. As Merrimack, after that first down, is going to come out in the victory formation. This one might be elementary from here, folks. As Crampton takes a snap, takes the knee. As that first down completion, just a few moments ago to Shea Goodwin, is going to put this game on ice here. In what was a terrific matchup between two very well coached, very talented, and evenly matched teams here tonight.
Yeah, Dave, really an incredible game. You had a really strong feeling out process that first quarter, an absolute spectacular offensive explosion in the second, another kind of feeling out process in that third quarter before Merrimack was able to kind of put their stamp on the game in the fourth, put on two scores. Alvirne answered back late, but just wasn't quite enough.
Wasn't quite enough there as Merrimack able to protect the football here in the fourth quarter, and it got interesting there for a little while, but they're able to close this one out here in the victory formation with Crampton taking a knee as you see the team going out there to celebrate, getting ready for the handshake here at midfield. As it's official now, folks, your Merrimack Tomahawks 35, the Broncos of Alvirne High 28. Big win here for Merrimack High. This is their second win of the year. Really just a terrific game across the board here. So want to thank you for joining us tonight. Also want to thank the Merrimack TV staff again. Want to thank David McGinnis, media assistant, who's on camera tonight at the game. Want to thank assistant media services coordinator Justin Slez, who is back here in the studio with Ralph and I producing us. And as always, want to thank media services coordinator Nicholas Lavalley as well. This has been a tremendous night of football here, folks. Thank you again so much for joining us. Your Merrimack Tomahawks have defeated the Alvirne Broncos by a score of 35-28 in what was a terrific game. On behalf of Ralph Carpentier, I've been Dave Carter. Thank you all so very much for joining us tonight, and have a wonderful weekend. Take care, everybody, and good night.